how we sing and how we serve. Amen.
Amen.
You might remember 5 years ago, the Episcopal Church of New Hampshire went in search of a new bishop, and three candidates were selected. Our region hosted a series of walkabouts, meaning bishop candidates back then did what presidential candidates are doing now. They traveled around different places, shared their thoughts, answered questions. At one walkabout, every candidate was asked, "What type of bishop will you be?" One replied, "I will be stable, I will be steady, I am ready to work hard, but I will not take big risks." If you're looking for someone to make national headlines, go out on a limb, I am not the leader for you. I remember listening and agreeing with her, thinking, "Girl, I got you." I was the kid who never climbed a tree, the only child in grade 3 who never touched the top of the climbing rope, who never got her name on the Tarzan and Jane poster. But I also remember thinking, "Friend, you just blew it." So glad you were honest, but no leader, no person should ever endeavor to never go out on a limb. Take a risk. And sure enough, that particular bishop candidate did not become your grace. She lost the race. Today, we hear a story unique to Luke about a man who went out on a limb to see Jesus. So many who cross paths with Christ in scriptures are nameless, but here we actually hear a name, Zacchaeus. Theologian Henry Nouwen five times. And a tax collector also prayed, but unlike the Pharisee, humble, holy, please. So Luke helps us see how Jesus dined with, defended, hired, inspired, welcomed, celebrated tax collectors. But no matter how much Luke pumps them up, bottom line, tax collectors were next door neighbor traitors. Men who worked for the Roman occupation, fellow Jews with their ears to the ground, so when word got around, someone had made a little bit more money. Tax collector would show up at the door. Finally, for their success, skim off the top. And Zacchaeus was the worst of the worst. No matter that his name means pure, innocent, righteous one, he's the only chief tax collector mentioned in the Gospels, meaning Zacchaeus was the best of the best, maneuvering all the rest to collect taxes for the enemy.
Challenge.
sets his sights on what he wants. And when people grumble and trash talk Zacchaeus, saying he's a sinner, Zacchaeus refuses to accept the negative garbage, the words the world has handed him. Today's translation, we heard Zacchaeus say, "I will give to the poor. I will pay people back." But those verbs are not in the future in the Greek. They're in the present tense. Zacchaeus actually said, "Here and now, I give. Here and now, I pay back. Right now, I begin again. I embrace not how the world sees me, but how God sees me. I am not what I do. I am not what I have. I am not what others say about me. It is who I pray to, who I belong to, that matters. My favorite story about Helen Keller, of course, involves an Episcopal bishop. She was curious about her creator, so her teacher Annie Sullivan took Helen to see Philip Brooks, the rector of Trinity Church Boston, eventual Bishop of Massachusetts. And the moment they met, Brooks made a deliberate choice on how to seek